Last class we did a whole bunch of varsity push, right?
Yes.
But just on one side, right?
Yes.
Cool. So I think naturally we should do the other side since we're getting the moves down. So, and you know, for pretty much all your moves, you could switch the sides. But generally for practicing here, since we sort of practice around what the test will have, and this is one where both sides could be on the test. Does that make sense? Because both varsity pushes are on them. Okay. Y'all want to try to remember it on your own, see what you got, or do you want me to show you something?
I think I need to show
you. Yeah, sure.
Because I remember a little bit, but...
So yeah, so for brush knee push. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's three pieces, basically. Punch comes in and you meet it, so you don't get hit.
Drop.
Two, drop your weight, step out. And then three, keep contact on both while you shift and turn. So do you want to review the first side? Yeah, why don't you review the first side a couple times, and then we'll do the other side after that. Would be no let go of the left hand. Like you have it for part of it, just keep it on as much as you can. Very good. Similar correction though. Meet it like you did. Drop it like you did. And then when you're pushing, keep that friction on the left side as much as you can. So keep like pushing on their arm with it while you.
Okay.
There you go. Yeah. Same way, we try to face it like the form, keep the memorization connected. But so now it's going to be a left punch. I'll do it. So now it's going to be a left punch. I'm going to meet it with the right hand. Don't get hit. Drop the weight. Sorry, I'm rushing it. I want to show it smoothly. But yeah, so meet it. Just rest the hand. Does it feel right? Makes sense?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. Do you need to see anything else or are you ready to try?
I'll just try.
Alright, that's the good answer.
That's what I like, that's my instinct too.
Yeah.
So like
stop it, yeah. Good, and back heel stay down. Cool. Switch.
Having it done on them as well than the other ones.
Yeah.
Well, one slight correction that I've been leaving out just to not do too many things at once is you do want to push like right in the middle if you can. Because otherwise you can roll with it. If you can get, this is part of like the push hands training, is like feeling for the center in your push. So take the time to like try to get like right in the center, left and right, and see if that, maybe that'll make it feel more the same on both sides. Yeah. So, how many different parts? Push wise? Okay, keep trying.
And push is kind of, for me, it feels kind of same. But I mean, the point contact, it's still.
Yeah. Any questions so far? All right, so that has two elements. One is a simple, relatively simple element, but it's really important and powerful in Tai Chi, and that is turning. So in the first one, well, forget the first one, let's do it in this context of this one. So this is like getting the body to turn with Tai Chi. If I don't turn, here's what it will look like. I'll meet it here, I'll drop it here, and then I'll push. That's okay, that's fine. But then if I want to make it Tai Chi, see how my shoulders have turned? Now I keep that turn when I drop, and then when I touch, I have a little extra to, from the waist and the hips. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm just starting to get a feel for turning the body to get the arms to move. Yeah, good. Step narrow if you want to, yeah. Yeah, you just kind of.
I gotta get on the panel, right?
Yeah, exactly. You probably want to step just outside your foot, yeah. Here's a general application thing. At the end of it, check yourself like you're in your form. I know we do the thing where we imagine the opponent in the form, but when you're actually doing the application, check if you end up like this or anything, just kind of sit it back like, okay, I'm gonna not overshoot. Because it's all about just like not overcommitting your balance, right?
That's my problem. I feel like I get into a low stance.
Yeah.
I feel balanced, but I know I'm too.
A little tip for him, yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. It ends up delivering a little less force than you might want to if you were really following through, right? But then you'll find other strengths in it. You're saying if they were too, the size difference was too much? Yeah. At some point, if the size difference was too much, you might just yield.
Yeah, because there's like, guys in the kung fu class, like, would that really work?
Yeah.
Probably not.
And you will get the person that's just gonna drop their weight on you and make you like, okay.
Yeah.
I get it.
Dropping your body a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly. Okay. Any other questions on it? Did you both get, like, feel like you did it enough? Okay. Two more things about applications in general that I keep forgetting. One is you might get a partner who starts anticipating what you're doing and resisting against that. And that's really not what we're trying to do in the applications. When you're the attacker, you want to pretend like you don't know the Tai Chi trick yet, right? So you'll get, this will happen with your partner, that they'll start like actively pushing against the way that you're about to go, even though it hasn't even gotten to that part yet. You know what I mean?
I do. Yeah. We teach it the opposite way, because we do a lot of those knee breaks. It's like, no, anticipate it, but go with it, because you're going to...
Oh, right. So you don't break.
Yeah.
So especially with the grabbing stuff and chin, uh-huh. I don't know if you've been Mr. Man, and he's like, it's like, I know what you're going to do, and I'm just holding you in place. And then, the other thing is, we're learning in pieces, but the connection of the changing of direction is what makes this stuff really cool once you get it down. So like, we learn it like, either punch on the appropriate side. So you learn it here, 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 right? And then through practice, without rushing it, you'll get to a point where it'll just be like, right? So this goes directly to the end of this. Right? That's all. I'll just say two things. Any other questions before we go on? Oh, let's do this. Let's go over a few minutes. Let's do the move, alternating side to side and just picturing the opponent each side. So we'll travel, like you know how brushing push 2, 3, and 4 to switch sides? So let's keep doing that and keep imagining our opponents as we do it. So here's one punch. And you push. And notice there's a nice little shift back before the punch comes in. There's a second one. Push. Shift back, turn. Yeah, good. Kind of starts to feel a little different. But does that make sense? Okay, let's do our life skill. Path of self-mastery requires a focused mind. Focused mind sees no obstacles. Path of self-mastery requires a focused mind. A focused mind sees no obstacles. Path of self-mastery requires a focused mind. A focused mind sees no obstacles.
That'll
beginner students. Black Sash training dismissed. Very good.